Okay. In Turkey, Turkish students increasingly resisting religious, reli sorry, increasingly resisting religion, a study suggests. Recent polls in Turkey have indicated that there is a decline in religious youth who describe themselves as, quote, less religiously conservative than older generations. Results indicated, quote, people who described themselves as religiously conservative was 7%, down from 32% in 2008. And fasting during Ramadan has declined from 77% to 65%. With trends like this, it seems Turkey's youth are starting to turn away from religion. So do you guys want to give your input before I go to my notes?
Yeah, I mean, this shows how disconnected the world of politics is from demographics right now when it comes to religion. Like worldwide, almost everywhere on the planet, on the globe that you put your finger on, religion is becoming demographically is losing. Okay, more and more people are abandoning religion. More and more are becoming atheists. But at the same time, for some reason, and I think I know the reason, I'll tell you why. Almost everywhere on the planet that you put your finger on, politically, religion is becoming more powerful. So we have more people on our side. Yes, less we're losing power. How is this happening? And again, this is a recent trend. If you look at it like a longer trend, that's not the case. Longer trend, we're winning. But shorter trend, we're losing politically. Religion is becoming more and more influential in politics almost everywhere for some reason. Almost everywhere. There are exceptions, even though demographically we're winning. In Turkey is a great example. Turkey is becoming more and more Islamic politically, even though people are becoming more less and less religious demographically. The reason is, and I want everybody to pay attention, okay? The reason is because stupid atheists go out and say stuff like, "Ew, we shouldn't be political. Why should we be political? We don't want to be like religion. Why should we get together and become politically active? Why should we create communities? If I wanted to create a community, I would be like, oh, that would be a church. That would be like a mosque. That I would stay religious if I wanted to do that." Well, keep saying that. This is how you're losing. This is how you're losing, okay? Keep giving all the monopoly over political activism, over community, over charity. Give all of that. Like, hey, religions, you claim to own these things, and we're not going to challenge you on that. Just keep them. We don't want them, and that's why we're going to lose everything we want. That's why we're going to lose positions in courts. We're going to lose laws that are going to be against women, against gay people. We all these we're gonna have a lot more laws against trans people, against science, because we don't want to get together because it's too icky. It's too much like religion, and it just gives me flashback how it used to be when I was religious in religious communities. Just give up everything. Give up everything. But anyways, that was my.
They just think any kind of community is religion.
Yeah.
But my answer would have been that because the world is being controlled by boomers and Gen X, and these people are mostly religious. Also, do you think, like, because the governments are getting more and more religious and conservative, that's why the young people who are being rebellious against that are turning atheists? Do you think that's possible?
I don't know. I think it's just more access to information, online information. I
That
think.
is something. And even, for example, like I'm taking India, for example, Hinduism. There are lots of Hindu atheists who, because they don't want to leave their religion, but they're kind of atheists, but they still don't want to leave their religion. Okay, so there would be people who are like, okay, hey, I'm an atheist because of this information I have, but I don't want to leave my former religion. And they can just come up with any term or something. But these people, they see because their religions, their former religions, are how they're affecting the government and other people. That's why they're saying, no, I'm leaving my religion and I'm an atheist and stuff like that. Because
Yeah.
even in India, there are not just Hindu atheists, there are proper atheists, like without any kind of religion and stuff.
Yeah, actually, complete anti-Hinduism, atheism is growing in India, and we need to highlight that. Okay, we need to We don't like the, we don't these wishy-washy people that are like, oh, there's this, I'm an atheist, but cultural stuff beautiful. I'm gonna defend the backwards, barbaric ancient religion because I just have some nostalgic memories of it. No, fuck that. There's enough of atheists in India that are saying like no to backwards belief that we could get that will get behind what we're doing here. Rachel is in Facebook is saying this is good and bad. Good because more freedom of choice in what to believe in, but bad because we all know how Erdogan is hostile towards everything except Islam. I mean, that's just a reaction that governments are going to have to the rise of atheism, right? You get Saudi Arabia calling out atheism as an act of terror. You see Egypt trying to make atheism illegal. They wouldn't be doing these things if we weren't a threat. I mean, that's a sign that we're growing. So that's a positive and negative because it's negative because fuck these governments trying to silence us, but also a good thing because it shows that we're growing, that they're doing this.
Yeah, to bring it back to Turkey for a second. So as we know, Erdogan has this agenda to build a religious generation and like work for the construction of a new civilization, supposedly. But the good thing is that this half of this country, which is 82 million people, give or take, is under 30. So it is a primarily younger population. And if the younger population is pushing against this certain brand of religiosity that's being shoved down their throats, I think that gives us a lot of cause to hope.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, would you highlight in the live chat, Aaron, he was asking a question, so I thought I would reply to that.
Give me a timestamp.
Yeah, 7:19 a.m.
Just wait, 7:19? I'm seeing everything as 9 a.m. Okay, wait, it should be 9:19 for me. Wait, that doesn't make sense.
It should be 10:09, I guess.
9:59. Hold on. No, there's no 9:59. Just read it out. I can't find it.
Okay, so Aaron was saying most Hindus are not very religious on average. Do you agree?
Found it. Okay.
Okay, so not this one.
Not that one. Right here. There we go.
Yeah, so most Hindus the way they act and the way they talk, I mean, you won't call them very religious, but most of them believe in God and rituals and everything. They're very superstitious. And also, I mean, the things they do usually are all mostly inspired by Hinduism. They think that's just their culture and stuff, but that's mostly Hinduism. So whatever they do, mostly those are based on religious practices in Hinduism. So it really depends on what you define as very religious.
Okay, but Shubham, try to respond to comments that is mostly about the topic that we're talking about, okay? But it's okay. Thank you for joining us. Subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell thingy. If you haven't, I don't know why. What's holding you back, okay? If you haven't subscribed to our channel, why haven't you subscribed to our channel? Explain that to us, please. Like, bell, and also, If you're not getting notifications and stuff because YouTube is not telling people that we have shows, because YouTube is like, oh, this person told us that they want to get your shows, right? They want to get your videos, but nah, we think it's no. And look, oh, they also hit the bell button, but nah, you guys are too controversial. We want to show them mainstream stuff. We want to show them CNN or cat videos or whatever. But even there are people like, no, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we don't think you want this. They're like, no, please show it to us. We say to you, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we think we know what's better for you than you yourself. So to solve that, there's a link in the description, which is to our newsletter. So hopefully we could email it to you. So hopefully you get some of our content that way. Okay. So yeah. Subscribe to our newsletter as well. And share our videos because, you know, we do get demonetized. That's an obvious on every one of our videos. So F that. But we don't care about that anymore. But we also get deprioritized. And that's even more damaging to us. Deprioritized, what does that mean? That means we don't show up on the suggested, you know, videos on the right and all that, you know, on people's homepages. And that's how channels grow. Unfortunately, we can't grow. So we need you guys to share our videos. So